Hello, my name is Gary Usher. I've got with me Isaac Heffernan. The two of us are going to be opening up a restaurant in Chester. What we're going to do today is we've got some pork here, we've got some onions here for a stuffing. Isaac's got the bread, which he's going to pull apart now. It's going to go in the stuffing when it comes off the stove. I'm going to show you how to take this pork apart and how to stuff it. Your pork belly will come normally with these ribs attached. You just take your knife underneath, follow the ribs, and they'll just easily come off. Leave those ribs over there.
Someone up on that wall is just going to spend the night with my girl.
So my pork's open now. So just those last little bits there right to the corner. You want to be really fussy, open it right out. So what I've got now is a nice sort of open pork belly there. I'm going to grab my seasoning now. It goes quite heavy on the salt. It's going to be in the oven for a good 8 hours, if not longer. Pepper as well. And then we're going to stuff it. Okay, I'm going to tell you a little bit about the stuffing now. So I've got my onion, golden raisins, amaretti biscuits, thyme. So I've got my onion, doesn't matter how you chop it. I'm going to take it down the middle there, just to make it slightly smaller. I'm just going to chop it, just rough chopping. So I've got all my ingredients, everything I need. So just ready for me to cook now. So I'm going to cook it all, and then we're going to stuff that belly, and I'll show you how to tie it. So veg oil, in with my onions. And in my onions there, I've got my garlic already mixed in. Onions are just slowly cooking there, in goes my thyme. Just chop really roughly like that, thyme goes in there. In goes all my golden raisins. So raisins are in there, so they're ready now. You can see there the raisins, they've just gone lovely and plump now. Take the mix, put it into a cold bowl. Bread goes in. Same with the amaretti. All we're gonna do with this is we're just gonna crush it up. So don't need to use anything other than your hand, just crush it in there. You see that powder's gonna soak it all up really lovely in with the bread there. Mix that in. You can see now, it's looking like a stuffing. Just throw this into the middle there. It doesn't have to be really accurate, it doesn't have to be spread out really neatly, just pile it in. I've got my stuffing there in the middle. And don't forget that I seasoned this really well. Although I seasoned the stuffing, I also seasoned the inside of the belly really well as well. I'm just gonna fold it out now. It's like it sort of falls back into place where it was. Really simple, I'm not looking to do anything that wasn't there before already, before I cut it. Try and keep the shape that's already in, so I'm just going to pretty much just turn it over, just give it one fold there. You can see already it's round already, so I'll just bring it nice and easy for me to work with on my board. Tying, and I said before that I can make this really easy, and I think I can. Pull a string, and do use butcher string. What you want to do first, you don't need to do any fancy work with it first, just tie a knot in it. So just lift it under there. What you'll find is you can just sort of guide it under there, and just sort of you can sort of pull it through like that without moving the meat too much. You're just sliding it. So I just got the first knot there, just a normal knot. There's no tricks to this, just a normal knot. Just tie it once, as you would tie a shoelace, normal knot. So you got your string, get your hand, just put it right over your wrist there. You've got that, and then just twist your hand around. It's so easy. So I've got my loop now, and all I'm going to do. It's just grab that loop, just pull, all I've done is pull my hand out, grab the loop, squeeze it under there. So what you do to finish this off, just turn it over, just roll it over. Just get them all sort of even out. Cut it to about here, so I can see that I've got the length of the pork. I've got plenty more as well, so cut it about here. That's coming from the top. And all I'm going to do is put it through the first one, just underneath. And all we're going to do is go under and over. And what that does, it just creates a bit of a seal on the bottom. We'll put it all the way across there. So all I'm going to do is just tie this together. Again, no fancy knots here. No fancy butcher's knots, just a knot. So, like I say, like doing laces, just a knot. Tie it. And we're done. Just get rid of that sort of excess string there. It doesn't matter about that bit hanging off, doesn't do anything. What we're going to do now is cook it. put it in, get the crackling on 275 on your highest temperature. When you see the crackling come up all the way over, when it's completely covered, turn your oven down, about 100 degrees. No more than 100, but you can go less if you want. And you sort of 8 to 10 hours, and you should get an absolutely just a stonking pork belly. It'll be crispy on the outside. It'll just be the most unbelievably tender, juicy, all the fat will have rendered. It'll be just the greatest piece of pork. And that's your pork belly. What I've done, I've taken four slices already, and all I did was literally just take those slices and just put them onto a tray with nothing. But I have turned the oven up quite high. It was on about 200 degrees actually, just to reheat these, because what I want is to make sure that skin is nice and crispy there. So just put a little bit of mash on each plate. You see it's sort of orange colour now, so it's got sweet potato in there. When we say mash, we haven't actually put a masher to it. We've just cooked the potatoes and just crushed it with this spatula, actually. That's all we've used. Just plonk it there on that mash. It's really simple. Just some leaves here. These are actually some pea shoots. And you use this fine bit of salt and pepper. I've already put a little bit of olive oil in this. A bit of salt and pepper. Just throw them on anywhere you want. These are just the juices. Juices from the pork, and we just added a little bit of olive oil to them. So it's the pan juices, the little bit of olive oil. But the pork's so sort of, the pork just literally melts in your mouth. You don't really need any sort of, it's nice, you can put some sort of gravy with it if you want, but it really doesn't need it. And that's it, that's your pork belly. Crispy crackling, sage and onion stuffing, sweet potato mash, and just some dressed pea shoots, and that's it, really simple. Someone up on that wall is just gonna spend